Hi everyone, I am Dr. Rana Chaudhary and today we'll know about ovulation and how it regulates the body. If your menstrual cycles are regular, that is around 28 to 30 days, once the bleeding starts, that's called as the day 1 of your menstrual cycle. The follicle starts growing and somewhere around day 13, 14 or 15, the egg is mature and it ruptures. This rupture of the follicle and release of the egg is known as ovulation. What happens to the body temperature around that time? Well, post-ovulation there is an increase in the body temperature, which is also known as increase in the basal body temperature. This happens because after ovulation there is a change in the hormones. Once you get your periods, there is an increase in the hormone called as follicle stimulating hormone or FSH. This causes the growth of the follicle. Once you ovulate, there is an increase in the LH and the progesterone, which causes slight increase in the body temperature. The developing follicle starts growing once you get your menses from the day 2 and 3 of your menstrual period. The dominant follicle, that is follicle size more than 8-10 millimeters, starts growing and somewhere in your mid-cycle, maybe on day 13th, 14th or 15th, the mature egg is released from the follicle. The remaining shell forms the corpus albicans and the corpus luteum. If there is no pregnancy, the remaining shell gets absorbed. Simultaneously, there is an increase in the endometrial thickness or the endometrial lining, which grows and grows and prepares for receiving the baby. This is called as the secretory phase of the endometrium. On ultrasonography, the endometrium looks hyperechoic and homogeneous in this secretory phase or the post-ovulation phase of your menstrual cycle. The thickness of the endometrium in this phase should at least be more than 7.5 millimeters for the embryo to come, attach and then grow. Thank you everyone for watching.